Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. Let's start the current affairs for a new fresh day, 10th of September. Before I start the video, 3 days back, there was an exam. It was for the post of primary teacher and it was organized by Atomic Energy Education Society, right? So in this exam, there were a lot of current affair questions. I selected 8 questions out of, I gathered from various sources. And I would like to discuss these 8 questions with you, okay? So first, I will discuss with you the question. Then I will give you 30 seconds to answer or to gather your thoughts. You need not write in comments. And then I will tell you the answers also, okay? So let's see. Because one thing I've noticed is if any particular set of current affairs, they appear in one exam, then chances are they would be asked in other exams also. So first question is, which Indian sports person has clinched India's first gold medal in the recently concluded Jakarta and Palembang 18th Asian Games? So who won the first gold medal in these Asian Games for India? Second, Kofi Annan, who passed away recently. He is the ex-United Nations chief. He was born in which country? He was from which African country? Third, the central government has proposed to set up which committee to suggest changes to see the JEE Advanced Examination? So basically, JEE Advanced Examination, they want some amendments to be made, and for that, a committee has been constituted. Fourth is, which IIT has decided to set up a re-water research center to replenish and rejuvenate water resources in India? That is essentially to make sure that the water table, which is already depleting, it does not deplete further. Which city was the venue of the recently concluded 11th World Hindi Conference for 2018? Recently tested anti-tank guided Helena is a helicopter launched version of which missile? And the International Tiger Day is observed on which day? And Prime Minister recently, from the rampart of the Red Fort on his Independence Day speech, he had announced which human spaceflight program, okay? So these are the 8 questions. I hope you had a good look at it, and you get 30 seconds, and after that, I will tell you the answers. So your time starts now. Always remember that if you feel depressed at any point in time, then imagine yourself walking through a beautiful forest. And you know, one thing you'll realize is that most of the people who have had achieved success throughout the course of history or in the recent past, or you know, whoever you meet, if you find somebody successful, then always remember there is one thing that is common, which is that all of these people, they have learned how to fight loneliness. This is one virtue you will find common in all the people who have achieved success in life. So never be afraid of loneliness. Treat it as a blessing. Okay, so let's start now. Which Indian sportsperson won India's first gold? It was Bajrang Punia. Okay. Now, Bajrang Punia is a wrestler from Haryana and he won the first gold medal for India in the Asian Games. Kofi Annan was born in Ghana. And Ghana is in Africa. Capital is Accra. And by the way, all of these 8 questions should be easy if you have been watching my videos. In fact, when I discussed this particular question, I showed you where is Ghana on the map also, you know. And this I have repeated over and over. The Union government has proposed to set up which committee? So this committee will be headed by Bhaskar Ramamurthy. And Mr. Bhaskar Ramamurthy is the director of IIT Madras. This also I had discussed in depth when I had discussed this question. Which IIT has decided to set up a re-water research center? It is IIT Kharagpur. And Kharagpur is in Bengal. And by the way, IIT Kharagpur was the first IIT in India. Which city was the venue of the recently concluded 11th World Hindi Conference? It was Port Louis, capital of Mauritius. They are asking city, they are not asking the country. And Sanskrit conference took place in Vancouver in Canada. So don't confuse Hindi conference with Sanskrit conference. Recently tested missile Helena is helicopter launch version of missile called Nag. Okay, Nag is an anti-tank guided missile. Now it can be launched from helicopter. So by heli, we have suffixed the word Helena. Okay. The International Tiger Day, it's on 29th of July. This probably was the easiest of question. Now, on 29th of August, you have the National Sports Day, which is birthday of Major Dhyanchand. the great hockey wizard from India, 29th of August. And 29th of July is the International Tiger Day. India is home to 70% of the population of tigers in the world. Pradhan Mantri Modi, from his speech, we can conclude that, you know, this program is called Gagan Yaan. And he has a vision that by 2022, one Indian at least should be in the space. So this is called Gagan Yaan mission. Now, these are 8 questions, and let me tell you which are the difficult ones. So this probably is easy. Kofi Annan, this was a little difficult one. Committee question is the most difficult one, because it's not easy to remember name of the chairperson of a committee. And IIT, this one was easy. Hindi conference, this one is the easiest, I believe. Helena missile, this depends on how, you know, with what concentration you listen to me when I discuss questions. International Tiger Day, very easy. And space flight is one of the easiest. Okay, so I expect you to score at least 5 to 6. If you are very good, then maybe 6, 7, and if you are excellent, then 8. So if you have scored 8, then high five. Okay, now let's start the video. At the International Court of Justice, India has supported which country over its claim on Chagos Islands, which are under the United Kingdom's control in the Indian Ocean? We are supporting Mauritius. So there is a fight between Mauritius and UK. So let me explain to you this entire controversy. But first, Mauritius's capital is Port Louis. Mauritius is our good friend. No wonder we are supporting Mauritius. It is present in the Indian Ocean, and it's a very strategic location. In fact, at one point in time, Chagos Islands, they were supposed to be given to India also for docking our military base, but it didn't materialize. This gentleman is Prime Minister of Mauritius, Pravin Jagannath. And remember, 9th of January, which is Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. This is actually the day when Mahatma Gandhiji returned to India from Africa. And his homecoming is celebrated as Pravasi Bharatiya Divas, 9th of January. And our partner country for this will be Mauritius. So Pravin Jagannath will be inaugurating it along with Pradhan Mantri Modi. So that's about Mauritius. Now let me tell you what is this entire controversy. So this is Africa. By now you must be well versed with Africa. And this is Atlantic Ocean. This is Indian Ocean, right? To the east is the Indian Ocean. This is Madagascar. This is Seychelles. Now from Seychelles, we were supposed to get Assumption Island. We will get. Their president had come to India recently, some 2 months back, and he had promised we'll get getting Assumption Island to dock our military base. And this right here is Mauritius in the Indian Ocean. So let me zoom this portion now. Okay, this is our area of interest. Now look here. This is Mauritius. This is the capital of Port Louis. And if you come a little north, okay, then here you will find a group of islands. Now a group of islands is always called an archipelago. That is the word to describe a group of islands. So there are many small islands, and this is the what you call the Chagos Archipelago. Now Chagos are a disputed island between UK and Mauritius. They both exert their claim over this. The problem comes now, there is a third party also. How? So UK, so there are a lot of islands, like this is the Chagos Archipelago. There is this island called Diego Garcia. Now what UK did was, they gave Diego Garcia to America for making their military base. And today Diego Garcia is one of the most important military base of America. So now there is a third party involvement, and of course America will not go back. Now there is a fight between Mauritius and UK. UK is powerful. Now the case has been dragged to the International Court of Justice, headquartered in The Hague in Netherlands. We have an Indian lawyer also, if you remember, Dalveer Bhandari. He is also among one of the lawyers in the International Court of Justice. And a judgment is awaited. Let's see. But India is supporting Mauritius. Okay. Which state's chief minister has vowed to bring down malnutrition in the state, the malnutrition rate, by 11% by 2022? He is Jairam Thakur. He is the chief minister of Himachal Pradesh. Himachal Pradesh governor is Acharya Devvrat. And Shimla is the capital of Himachal Pradesh. He wants to bring down malnutrition rate by 11% by 2022. Reliance Infrastructure, the chairman of Reliance Infrastructure is Anil Ambani. Anil Ambani is the owner of this company, not Mukesh Ambani. So now they have won a court case against National Highway Authority of India. National Highway Authority of India is now under law obligated to pay what amount to Reliance Infrastructure to settle the dispute. It is 2 billion rupees or 200 crore rupees. Okay, 200 crore. Central government has selected how many government schools of Haryana for Swachh Vidyalaya Puraskar, which means clean school award, you know. And if you remember, Pondicherry had won the award for maximum number of cleanest schools of India. 7 schools were awarded. In fact, the cleanest school of India, which got a score 100 out of 100, was also from Pondicherry. So from Haryana, 3 schools have been selected. Which are these 3 schools? You need not know the name. Just these are the names of these 3 schools. And the cleanest school of India is this one. The government primary school in Kunichampat in Pondicherry. The government primary school in Kunichampat in Pondicherry is the cleanest school of India. And these are the cleanest railway stations of India. You might want to revise those. So these are, there are 2 categories, okay, A1 and A. A1 is what you call the big railway stations and A are the small railway stations. So among the big railway stations, Jodhpur is the cleanest, second cleanest is Jaipur, and third is Tirupati in Andhra, Chittur, okay. So these are the 3 cleanest railway stations in India. Let's talk about the small ones. So among small ones, Marwad in Rajasthan, Marwad railway station. Second is Fulera railway station and third is Warangal in Telangana. Now, can you tell me Fulera railway station is in which state? Can you write in comments? So mark these up. Which country will be Jharkhand's partner country at the processing summit that is due in November? So a processing summit will take place in November in Jharkhand, and I'll tell you why it will take place. So there is a place in Jharkhand called Getalsud, okay. Getalsud is in Ranchi, and yesterday I told you that there was a mega food park that was supposed to be built in Getalsud in Ranchi, but it wasn't to be, and now this is due for auction. So Jharkhand has a problem of overproduction, and they don't even have good cold storage. So to give you an example, tomato is a popular crop in Jharkhand, and this year there was 35 million ton of a tomato produce, but hardly 15 million ton is used or will be used for eating and other things. Where will the remaining 20 go? So the farmers, they are forced to, you know, dump it. And therefore, we need food processing. Okay, we need mega food parks in Jharkhand. And for that, they are now organizing a processing summit, and it will take place with the help of China. So China is the partner country for the same. Jharkhand CM is Mr. Raghubar Das, who has taken over as the commandant of the Air Force Academy in Dundigal. So Dundigal is a place in Telangana. It is around 40 kilometers away from Hyderabad. Here we have the Air Force Academy. This is very, very important. And the new commandant will be Mr. Arvinder Singh Butola. And Mr. B.S. Dhanoa, he is the Air Chief Marshal, that is the Chief of the Indian Air Force. Which state government has declared the Singh Phan Wildlife Sanctuary as an elephant reserve? And this will become the 30th reserve for jumbos or elephants in the country. Elephant reserve is a status given to a reserve. Like for example, we have a Koringa reserve in Andhra, or we have a Kameng elephant reserve in Arunachal Pradesh. So basically, elephant reserves are the safe havens for elephants. And this status is awarded to various wildlife sanctuaries. And the latest is Singh Phan Wildlife Sanctuary. It is in Nagaland. So let me show you in the map where is Nagaland. So this is our Northeast India. Here we have Arunachal, then we have Nagaland. Okay. So remember it like this. We have Arunachal Pradesh, then Nagaland, and then MM, which is Manipur and Mizoram. Mizoram is the southernmost. So here we have Nagaland, capital is Kohima, and Mr. Nifu Ryo is the Chief Minister of Nagaland. Now you should remember 2 or 3 things more about Nagaland. These are the 5 protected areas in Nagaland. One is a national park. The only national park in Nagaland is the Intanki National Park. Intanki is actually the name of a river, and you know, since it is near river and it is called Intanki National Park, it is in Paren district in Nagaland, and you can see the size also, it is by far the largest. Then we have 4 wildlife sanctuaries. One is called Fakim, it is in Kaifar district, Pulibadze in Kohima, Rangapahar in Dimapur, and Singhafan in Mon district, Nagaland. So Singhafan Wildlife Sanctuary is now the 30th elephant reserve of India. So very, very important question. The Union government has doubled the pecuniary limit or the monetary limit to rupees what? Lakh for filing a loan recovery application in the debt recovery tribunal by banks and by financial institution. So basically the registration or the, if you want to file for a loan recovery, then earlier the limit was 10 lakh. Okay. Now the limit is 20 lakh. That is the pecuniary limit. So it has been doubled. Which country's police academy has announced that it will ban women from enrolling into the academy? So basically, this country has said no to the recruitment of women in the police forces. It is Thailand. Thailand's capital is Bangkok. It's an ASEAN country. Which country is going to move its Israel embassy from Jerusalem to Tel Aviv? Jerusalem is the capital of Israel and shekel is the currency of Israel. And remember, Haifa is the city of Israel, after which Tin Murti Marg in New Delhi has been named. There is a Tin Murti Marg, it's a road in New Delhi which has been named after Haifa, and Benjamin Netanyahu is the Prime Minister of Israel. And Hebrew is the language that is spoken in Israel. Hebrew is the language in which the Holy Bible is also written. Now, this has become the third country to shift its embassy from Jerusalem to Tel Aviv. First was America, second was Guatemala, and third now is Paraguay. Paraguay is a South American country, and the capital of Paraguay is Asuncion, and Guarani is the currency. Guarani. The Union government has appointed which former Reserve Bank of India governor as the head of the panel that has been tasked with selecting India's next chief economic advisor? So, who was India's chief economic advisor? Mr. Arvind Subramanian. Right? Mr. Arvind Subramanian was the chief economic advisor. Now he has retired. Okay? He has abdicated his post, and therefore this post is lying vacant. And since this is one of the most important posts, because even the economic survey is given by the chief economic advisor every year, one day before the budget. So, who is entrusted with selecting India's next economic advisor? It is Bimal Jalan. The panel will be headed by Bimal Jalan. Bimal Jalan is also the ex-governor of the Reserve Bank of India. Which Indian shooter has won the gold medal in the junior 10-meter air pistol event at the ISSF World Championship? ISSF is headquartered in Munich. Now, pay attention, 10-meter air pistol, okay, and 10-meter air rifle, both are different. See, guns are of various kind, right? So there is a rifle, you can see in the photo. The upper one is the rifle and the lower one, the small one, is the pistol. So if they ask pistol, then the answer is Saurabh Chaudhary. He is from Meerut in western Uttar Pradesh. And if they ask rifle, then the answer is Hriday Hazarika. Hriday Hazarika. Okay, so the answer is different for pistol and rifle. Don't get confused. Which player has won the US Open 2018 by defeating the great Serena Williams? Serena Williams is from America, so obviously she was the home favorite, but she has been beaten by Naomi Osaka. And I saw this match, and there was a fight that Serena Williams had with the referee, and he was a Spanish referee, and he did not pay any heed to the stature of Serena Williams, and she got even more angrier because of that, and there were things, but okay, Naomi Osaka was the worthy winner. And that's how it went. So she's Naomi Osaka. By the way, the Japanese players, some of them are really world class. So let me tell you 2-3 more which can be asked. So there is this player called Rikako Iki. Okay, and this time in the Asian Games, she won 8 medals, out of which 6 were gold medals. One player won 6 gold medals. Okay, and she was Rikako Iki. She is a swimmer, Japanese swimmer, and she was awarded the most valuable player at the Asian Games, and she has become the first ever female to be given most valuable player status at the Asian Games, in the history of Asian Games. Okay, so she is Japanese. And then we have a tennis player, male tennis player, Kai Nishikori. Kai Nishikori has been playing well for the past 4 or 5 years, but in the recently, you know, this US Open, Kai Nishikori was able to reach up to semi-finals. This is a huge achievement, and he was only to be humbled by Novak Djokovic. So Novak Djokovic will play Del Potro. The match, by the way, is going on as I'm making this video. So tomorrow I will ask you who won the men's US Open this time. Okay. There is one more, by the way, Japanese player. I forgot to tell you. Badminton player, Nozomi Okuhara. Okay. She can also be asked, because she has been performing very well also for the past 2 years now. Nozomi Okuhara. Okay, which Indian shooter has won the men's double trap gold medal in the ISSF World Championship? This is his one of the finest performances. He is Ankur Mittal. Ankur Mittal is from Haryana. What is the name of the famous Odia poet who will be honored with the prestigious Sarala Puraskar for his poetry collection called Misra Drupad? Misra Drupad is poetry collection of Mr. Shatrughna Pandav. Shatrughna Pandav. Ayushman Bharat call center was formally inaugurated in which cities recently? Ayushman Bharat is a health insurance scheme where 5 lakh rupees is the limit for one family per year, and 10 crore families will be covered. It is one of the largest insurance schemes in the world for health insurance, and its call center has been inaugurated in Bangalore. That Bangalore will also host the Aero Show in 2019. The Minister for HRD, Human Resource Development, Mr. Prakash Javadekar, he has inaugurated the 4th World Summit on Accreditation. In which city? It was inaugurated in New Delhi. Whenever they ask the location for any conference, 99% the answer will be New Delhi. Which Indian athlete has created history by becoming the first Indian to win a medal at the IAAF Continental Cup? No Indian before him has won a medal in this event. His name is Arpinder Singh. And Arpinder Singh is from Amritsar in Punjab. Okay. Now, let me tell you here that Arpinder Singh had also performed brilliantly at the Asian Games. He in fact won the gold medal. In fact, he won the gold medal on 29th of August, which is the National Sports Day, birthday of Major Dhyan Chand. And so he is a triple jump player. Triple jump. What will be the slogan for 2019 elections for Pradhan Mantri Modi? So whether he will be able to reconquer, you know, his throne, or whether he will have to abdicate, remains to be seen. And Pradhan Mantri Modi, if you remember last time, it was Ab Ki Bar Modi Sarkar. This time the slogan will be Ajay Bharat Atal BJP. Ajay Bharat Atal BJP. Which country has withdrawn from the first BIMSTEC military exercise that was supposed to be held in India in Pune? First BIMSTEC military exercise, Nepal will not participate. This is a huge thing that Nepal has backed out. And also Nepal is going closer to China. In fact, they have been allowed some ports access by China, because Nepal is a landlocked country. It depends heavily on Indian ports like Kolkata and other ports, Haldia port, etc. So now Nepal wants to let go of its dependence on India. So it has signed port agreement with China also recently. Pradhan Mantri of Nepal is KP Sharma Oli. And Bidya Devi Bhandari is the president of Nepal. Bobili Veena, okay, it's a musical instrument. It's also called Saraswati Veena or Ekanta Veena. It is basically a string instrument used in Carnatic classical music. It is made from which of the following trees? The tree is jackwood. Jackwood. Now don't confuse jackwood with jackfruit. Okay. Jackfruit is the state fruit of Kerala, official fruit of Kerala. Ghumura. Ghumura is an ancient folk dance that originated in which of the following states? Ghumura originated in Odisha. Odisha, they have a classical dance also called Odissi. Which of the following is not a variety of mango? Which of the following is not a variety of mango? Bangana Palle. Okay, I asked you, if I remember, I think some 3-4 days back, I asked you Bangana Palle. It's a geographical indicator tagged mango of Andhra Pradesh. Alfonso is Maharashtrian. Sindhura is also a mango. Red Daka is actually a banana. And by the way, I had asked you Changali Kudan banana also. That is in Kerala. So I keep asking you these things, and this will surely help you improve your GK. No, I don't want to say goodbye, because I want to make you revise this governor. Okay, so let's quickly see who are the latest governor. Let's quickly revise. I saw this in India Today. They have covered this nicely with photos. So where is it? Wait, let me refresh the page. Yeah. So here is the list of the governors of India. Let's quickly revise. Yeah. Mr. ESL Narasimha, he is the governor of for both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. And this is the very updated list. Okay. So today when I'm making this video, it is 10th of September, 3:30 a.m. in the morning. So this is updated. B.D. Mishra is the governor of Arunachal Pradesh. Brigadier B.D. Mishra. Jagdish Mukhi, Assam. Lalji Tandon, Bihar. He had replaced Satyapal Malik, who is now Jammu Kashmir's governor. Anandiben Patel, Chhattisgarh, because Chhattisgarh governor Balram Das Tandon, he recently passed away, and she is the governor for Madhya Pradesh also. Mridula Sinha, the famous Hindi writer, Goa. O.P. Kohli, Om Prakash Kohli, is governor of Gujarat. Satyadev Narayan Arya is the new governor of Haryana. He replaced Kaptan Singh Solanki. Acharya Devrat is new governor of Himachal Pradesh. Not new, actually, he was previously also. Satyapal Malik, Jammu and Kashmir. Satyapal Malik. Draupadi Murmu, Jharkhand. She is Draupadi Murmu. Vajubhai Wala, Karnataka. Vajubhai Wala. He was in news when the Karnataka elections took place this year. Mr. P. Satashivam, he was a justice, Kerala. He is smiling. Okay, Anandiben Patel, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh both. Ex-Chief Minister of Gujarat. C. Vidyasagar Rao, Maharashtra. For a long time, he has been now the governor of Maharashtra. Najima Abdullah, Manipur. Okay, Manipur. Tathagat Roy switched from Tripura to Meghalaya. Okay, so now he is Meghalaya's governor. Kummanam Rajashekaran, Mizoram, and Mizoram will go for elections very soon. So his role will be important. PB Acharya, okay, Nagaland. PB Acharya, Nagaland. Ganeshi Lal, Odisha, he is also new. He had taken over from Mr. S.C. Jamir. VP Singh Badnor, Punjab. VP Singh Badnor. Kalyan Singh, ex Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, is now the Governor of Rajasthan. Again, he has been for a long time. Ganga Prasad, Sikkim. Okay, so from Meghalaya to Sikkim, because Sikkim Governor Srinivas Patil retired. Banwari Lal Purohit is the Governor of Tamil Nadu. And ESL Narasimha, Telangana and Andhra, both. Kaptan Singh Solanki from Haryana to Tripura. So now he is Tripura's guy. Ram Nayak, the stalwart politician from Maharashtra, is now the Governor of Uttar Pradesh. And Baby Rani Maurya replaced KK Paul, Krishna Kant Paul, who had retired. So Baby Rani Maurya is the new Governor of Uttarakhand. Kesri Nath Tripathi is West Bengal. Okay. So, I hope you enjoyed the video. Okay, take care. See you tomorrow. Bye.